Dot-com boom, if you've read about it, if you weren't born, that's fine, but if you've read about it, it was one of the biggest boom and bust cycles that we've seen in recent history. And we were right there, not just contributing or participating in it, but making it happen. I was part of a company called MicroStrategy. Me and a bunch of guys started something called strategy.com, which went on to become one of the poster children of the dot-com boom. We went from about $100 million market cap company to about $40 billion in 2 years, right? And all of us had pretty much become multi-millionaires overnight because of our stock options. And, you know, so I'm here, a kid from the US. Until a couple of years back, I had no idea what I wanted to do. I'm suddenly sitting on millions of dollars of stock, mind you, not cash. I should have cashed it out, but, you know, such is hindsight. And we were booking Ferraris and Porsches and so on and so forth. We knew very little about the ways of the world. And as luck would have it, our company announced an accounting irregularity in March 12, 2000, I even remember the date, because that day the NASDAQ fell by about 1,100 points from 5,500. Our stock went from 666 to maybe 300. And by December of that year, the world had come to an end. Our $40 billion market cap company had come back to $60 million. Not only had we lost the millions of dollars each one of us was worth, we were all in debt. So that Ferrari never came. And that was the time that we all started to think about what to do next. And there was a lot of soul searching going on in the US at that point. I was lucky that I had started a small little site on the site in India. And so in the early 2000s, I decided to come back to India and see how the internet opportunity would unfold here. And that's when I started Charlie.com.